Being an administrator of any system isn't always an easy job. So many administrators want a system that just works well and isn't unnecessarily complex. Let me show you. Hi, Matt Barron, product specialist at InvGate. With InvGate Service Desk, you can quickly and easily make changes and improvements to your ITSM system. Before we get started, you can always grab a trial instance of our software at try.invgate.com and follow along. The first thing admins want to know is, how is this going to save me time, right? So first, in settings, if you're looking for a specific feature, there is a search box right here where you can simply search through the individual settings and find exactly what you're looking for. Second, the areas within settings are arranged in the order of implementation. So if you're new to InvGate, this should help guide your work. So let's go through some of these. General is pretty basic. It's exactly what you would expect. Company name, logo, and some branding options for not only your system, but also your self-service portals that your customers will use. Second, let's talk about users. This is where your foundation data begins, so you can import users and groups using Active Directory, Azure Active Directory, Okta, or any SCIM or Open LDAP source. The second feature is how those users are going to authenticate. For this, you can use the system itself, of course, or enable single sign-on through Google, Microsoft Identity, or any LDAP or SAML 2.0 source. Lastly, there are a couple details to give you control. You can build custom groups, companies, and locations to separate people and services. There's also an option to create roles and permissions to control access to your heart's content. This can be useful for managing communications, integrations, or just access to the various aspects of the system. Next up, we've got help desks. And this section is pretty self-explanatory. You'll find this dynamic section is great at supporting lots of different needs, but at a very basic level, you create the teams and structures that you need to properly manage work. For instance, here you can see that HR is a restricted group, so people can't just see those tickets. There might be personally identifiable information in there. Secondly, under IT, you see the specific groups and then the different levels. Within these groups, you're going to assign managers, agents, and configure details like how should work be assigned, as well as the working hours and how to handle automation. That can be found in this section here. This is how you can set up shifts and holidays for your different service desks. And it's going to also have other options for what to do with reassignment and after hours behaviors. Finally, there's a second area for setting the shifts and holidays for these help desks. The next big section, the catalog. This is where all the items live. So, creating the individual categories and items that people can interact with and order. And we give you lots of options here to make this easy. I won't go into all the details, but you can see that we've got options to add icons with a large library of icons for you to choose from. Of course, you're going to title these individual things, but we allow you to take this as far as you want. You can geek out on keywords, categories, maybe it's assigned to a specific help desk or a workflow. You can set up tons of automation like assignment rules, workflows, custom fields, custom forms, access rules, and a bunch of other details. Lastly, you can use the visibility rules section here to manage permissions and access. Very handy. Requests is an area that really just affects our back office teams. And there are a ton of features packed in here, from request numbering to collaboration options and into finer details like how work is handled. This is the area where policy really gets enforced and processes are supported. You'll also find options in here for things like customizations, custom fields, canned responses that your teams can use, time tracking, and approvals. But I do want to highlight automations, because this is a simple if this, then that rules engine that gives teams a ton of simple power to automate activities. Here we've got if the category is a printer one and the customer is a VIP, we reassign the request, we send an email, we change the priority, we add some observers and trigger an approval. So you can see this is really simple for people to administer themselves. You can also see that we've got SLAs or service level agreements in here in case you've got deliverable targets that you need to hit. And let's not forget workflows, which are super useful for graphical manipulation and an easy way to integrate with APIs. The knowledge base is pretty self-explanatory with some permissions and categories. And then we're back after knowledge base to some more administration heavy elements. Namely, here is where you configure incoming and outgoing email boxes, as well as customizations you can make to the individual email templates for every email that the system sends. And there are a ton of useful options in there. Then we get into a super powerful spot within integrations. You might want to have some of your asset information on your tickets. I know I do. So here's where I've added a connection to InvGate Insight. Next, there are some super useful applications that we already integrate with, like Teams and Zapier. And we're always adding integrations, so make sure you stay in touch to see what's coming next. You can also see what integrations we have by going to our website, invgate.com. Finally, InvGate has always supported an open two-way API integration, and there's some great documentation that makes this quite accessible. Lastly, there is a spot for you to manage key credentials so your service accounts aren't just listed within the same list as your employees and customers. Our last two sections are specifically for gamification, which we cover in the manager walkthrough, but here's where you configure the points and quests, as well as resetting the points and setting the duration. Last is the system area, which gives you access to some big tools like, oh, I don't know, erasing all requests, so don't click that button. But seriously, this is where you'll find the licensing information and the version information, some handy GDPR settings, and you know we need to keep good logs because it's a system. Now, that's basically it for what you're likely interested in as an admin. But if you want to see more or have specific questions, you can always check out our other videos or get in touch with us. The other videos we cover specifically are an agent walkthrough to talk about the individual ticket features that are included in the system for agents to be powerful, a manager walkthrough so they learn about dashboards and reports so you don't have to do that for them, and many, many more videos. So these are just some of the big features in InvGate Service Desk that are designed to make administration easy. For more on this topic, check us out on YouTube or discover our solutions by signing up for a trial at try.invgate.com. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope to see you again soon.